And we just got some new video from inside the bar during the shooting. I want to play it for our viewers for the first time, but I want to caution them. This is potentially disturbing. Watch this. Horrific, truly horrifying look inside the massacre. So, Kyung, you're there, you're on the scene. What are you learning tonight?
Well, the FBI is trying to figure out exactly why this man would do this. This is someone who multiple friends have told CNN that they simply don't understand, a normal guy, a guy who went to serve his country. So the FBI has been at his home, the home that he shared with his mother throughout the day, trying to piece the picture together of a disturbed mind.
We're now learning more about the gunman who turned this California bar into a gruesome crime scene. Investigators identified him as Ian David Long, a 28-year-old war veteran. He entered the bar just before 11:30 p.m., carrying a .45 caliber Glock and an extended magazine. Friends say the divorced former Marine had frequented the bar often, but Wednesday night, he came to kill.
We got multiple people down. We need a lot of ambulances.
Initial 911 dispatches from the scene only hint at the horror unfolding inside.
We have one victim who was shot and bleeding at the entrance.
College Country Night at Borderline Bar in Thousand Oaks, California, outside of Los Angeles, had drawn a crowd of more than 100 young patrons.
I saw him point to the back of the cash register, and he just kept firing.
He shot the front doorman, bouncer, but yeah, just a young man, and then he shot the cashier.
First responders rushed to the scene as survivors scrambled to escape.
Friends got the bar stools and they started slamming it against the window so we could get out.
Victims were carried out one by one and desperate life-saving efforts took place in the parking lot. Still, many remained inside.
We're still missing two people. We can't find them.
Parents now just beginning to learn which of their children will never return.
Oh, son, I love you so much. Oh, Heavenly Father, just please be with him.
The gunman was found dead inside the bar's front office, an apparent suicide, according to police. CNN has learned Long was a former infantry machine gunner who had served in Afghanistan. He was also known to police. Last April, law enforcement responded to a domestic disturbance at this Newberry Park home where he lived with his mother.
The mental health experts out there cleared him that day. The deputies went out to the call with the crisis team that felt he might be suffering from PTSD.
Richard Berg, who lives a block and a half away, tells us Long's mother feared for his future.
She might have been afraid of him herself. I don't know. She never said that. But she was living in hell.
Now, CNN did speak with several of the childhood friends of this gunman. One vaguely remembers this gunman mentioning that he had trouble sleeping. He had some nightmares, anxiety. But another friend who didn't hear anything like this, Wolf, says, quote, "I don't know what the hell happened." Wolf?
Awful story. R. Kyung, thank you very much. Kyung Law on the scene for us. In California. Let's bring in our CNN law enforcement analyst, the former FBI special agent Joshua Campbell. He's in Thousand Oaks for us tonight. Also with us, CNN counterterrorism analyst, the former CIA official Phil Mudd. Josh, you're there. You're out there in Thousand Oaks. Agents are searching the shooter's home, his car. What are they looking for?
Well, Wolf, the shooter is dead, so officers cannot interview him to try to get to the motive, to get to his rationale, what was going through his mind when he planned and then executed this deadly incident behind me. That leaves the physical evidence, the digital evidence, and other evidence that they're going to be looking for at the car, at the house, and the like, to go through in order to paint the picture of who this person was. We heard from law enforcement officers just a short time ago at a press conference. The FBI Los Angeles field office has their evidence response team here. They are going through the scene behind me, the bar where this happened. They're also looking at the car. They're looking at a residence. Again, trying to go through and find out, is there any evidence there that might indicate why the shooter did what he did? Perhaps a letter, a manifesto, some type of digital trace, social media evidence and the like. Again, a very lengthy, large-scale investigation that's underway right now, but that is what is going to be required in order to try to figure out why the shooting happened here, Wolf.
Phil, I want to show our viewers once again the very disturbing video that we just received from what happened inside this bar in Thousand Oaks right outside of Los Angeles. I want you to watch it as well. Let's discuss what we're about to see. So, Phil, what can authorities learn from this video? And I suspect there's probably going to be a lot more video they'll be reviewing.
Sure. I mean, you've got to look at the forensics from that. For example, the shells that were shot in that environment, what weapon they picked up there. But there's a broader question I'd be asking seeing that video, and it's something the FBI spoke about today with the sheriff's office, and that is motive. Somebody walked in rapidly to a dark environment, looked like they shot indiscriminately, and they shot a lot of rounds quickly. If you're looking to the motivation of that individual, that tells me obviously the individual wasn't picking out targets. Why did they select the location if we can presume they didn't select the individuals to hit? I think I looked at that video and took away that this is somebody who wanted to just go in and shoot as many people as he could without trying to determine who they were in the first place. The other thing I took away is just to spend a moment of silence saying, thank God there's a law enforcement officer who went into a dark environment, not knowing who would find in there. I mean, that obviously not a well-lighted situation, and sacrifice his life to go into a place that a lot of us, me included, I'm not sure I'd have the courage to do that. Incredible courage.